I set about building an extraction fan, as I do a lot of printing and prototyping on my Voron 0.1 that sits next to me, and it gets a bit smelly sometimes. I had two attempts at this, so I'll run through what I learned along the way. For the fan, decided to use PC cooling fans as they're quiet and quite cheap. PC fans are usually PWM fans or pulse width modulation fans, which means the PC's processor can control the speed of the fan. There's four wires, but you only need to wire up the positive and negative to a 12 volt power supply. If you don't wire up the two control wires, the fan just runs at 100%, which is perfect for our use. The picture shows which wires you connect to positive and negative. For the ducting, I wanted to try and use a small diameter duct so it wasn't so conspicuous. I got a piece of vacuum cleaner hose and design connectors to fit the profile. To connect to the printer enclosure, I didn't have any more acrylic sheet for the Voron's top hat, but then it occurred to me that I could print a new panel in ABS. And as you're designing it, you can design in the hole and the attachment points. And the panels can be printed on a 220 by 220 printer bed. For the outlet for the window, I designed a push fit connector to connect up to a window blank. So how did this version go? Well, it kind of worked, but it didn't move as much air as I hoped. You can see from the smoke test that it is working, but when connected up, you can still smell the print. And maybe there was some leakage too. It looked cool though with the LED lights. Back to the drawing board. I did some more research and decided to get a more powerful PC fan. The cheapest is not necessarily the best, so I checked the specs closely and spent an extra 10 bucks. So I just want to show you what I found with these fans. Is got this guy turned on there, and you can see the man, he blows pretty well, but he's a bit all over the place at times. But he goes okay. So initially I thought I'd use, when I was using plenty of this ducting, I'd just put this cone on top like this, and then we'll see how the air, but strangely, instead of air coming out, it actually sucks the man inside, which is kind of confusing. So after the research on major hardware's site, I tried the ducting with the vents from Nesto. Yeah, I should turn the fan off, but just slot that in there. There we go. Then we'll see how the air moves. And it's all blowing upwards now, nice and controlled. The really amazing thing is you put this guy on, and instead of being sucked in there, he just hangs up there and goes crazy. It's really powerful. So in conclusion, the diffuser and vents and everything from Nesto are awesome, definitely worth using if you're using one of these fans. For the ducting, decided to give in and play it safe with a bigger duct and go for a 100mm 4-inch diameter. And the results? It works really well. The big ducting looks a bit nuts on such a tiny printer, but you get absolutely no smell now. Another advantage is that it keeps the enclosure temperature down to 35 degrees, so I don't run into problems printing PLA with the extruder squishing the filament. Also, I noticed that the Raspberry Pi temperature stays around 39 degrees now, compared to getting up to 60 degrees before the fan. So air must be drawn through the electronics compartment as well, and that keeps the Pi, the SKR controller board and stepper motors cooler, which has got to be a good thing. I'll be building another one for my larger printer enclosure, as this works so well. Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye for now.